Okay, we are here with Michael Wokorach after the Kenya Simbas game versus Uganda. How was the game for you guys?
I think it was a tough game for us. We made quite a number of mistakes in the first half. Uh-huh. We tried to pick up in the second half, but I think it was too late for us to close that gap. But I think it was a good fight from our side. But at the end of the day, Kenya Simbas came and took over. But a win is a win. They did so many good stuff there on the pitch. But we're not letting heads down. We're still fighting.
And you're quite instrumental for your side, the Cranes. What was your mental coming into this game also?
I think from the loss against Namibia, we just decided to come and expose ourselves and try and play as much as we can and give back to the team. Yes, I didn't play Namibia, but these are Kenya games, and I always want to feature in the Kenya games because I know I can add something to the team, and I think it showed today. But however, it wasn't enough for the team to go forward and win.
And Rugby World Cup 7s is also next for you guys. What's the next goal that you guys want to achieve also at Uganda?
Yeah, there are a few players who have been on the 15s who play today actually, who we're supposed to travel to the World Cup on Friday.
Yeah.
I think the goal we have is we have a game against Samoa, which is the game that should advance us to the next stage. And we've been training hard for that game. We went to Stellenbosch for a camp in Stellenbosch, and our main focus is just to see how we can beat Samoa, then we can advance to the next level. But our mentors are all in, and we're going to throw in anything we can do just to go through that first that first game against Samoa, and then we shall see what we can do against England.
And many people might not know, or some people know, that you're the older brother of Philip Wokorach. Just tell us how your rugby journey has been from when you started to now playing in the Rugby Africa Gold Cup.
Basically, I started playing rugby in 2002. Uh-huh. I started playing rugby as tag rugby. I think most of you know it. And I grew through the ranks to playing for the national team. I've actually been playing for Uganda for the last 10 years now. I started playing when I was 19 years. That's when I joined the national team, and I think I'm still okay to go forward and maybe give it another 1, 2, 3 years, probably 5 years. But I think my journey has been good, and I'm very happy that whenever I can leave, there's a Philip Wokorach who will be representing out there.
Any goals that you still want to achieve in the sport? What's your vision still?
Right now, I'm just trying to play and see if I can push Uganda forward, and then my club back home, which is the Hima Heathens, and see if probably we can win more trophies with the club before Boyabi I can retire.
And lastly, for other people who are watching you, or the young people who are coming up in the sport, just tell them what they should do to perform or just be the best.
I think the most important thing is just you need to give your dedication into the sport. Uh-huh. Once you're dedicated, you're going to get the inspiration.
Yeah.
And once you're inspired, you're going to work hard to become a better player in future. So just keep the dream alive. Don't give up. I know there'll be challenges along the way. But once you're into the sport, it's very hard to come out of the sport. So just give it your all, and you have to go all hard. If you go play rugby when you're soft, it's going to be a problem for you. But if you go all hard, trust me, you'll enjoy your rugby, and you'll play for a while.
Cheers, and thanks for talking to us.
You're